morning and have you back. Gone 1 week and it feels like it's been forever. So praise God. Welcome to all that have come to worship our God this morning. May the Holy Spirit come and fill this place. May he bring to all of you peace, calm, and joy that will restore your soul, your mind, and your body for the week to come. Let's have church.
Good morning, all.
Good morning.
Good morning.
There are a few announcements today. The choir practice will be on Thursday at 7 o'clock, and we do welcome any new members. If you can carry a tune, even if you can't carry a tune, you can come up and fill a seat. Kids Cup will start September 28th at 6 p.m. On September the 29th, there'll be a one board meeting at 6:30 p.m. And then we do have a Sunday school class that meets at 9:30, and they are studying the life lessons from James. Are there any other announcements?
On the Sunday school, we will have one more lesson in James, and then we'll be doing something else. So if you're interested in coming, we'd be glad to have you. Maybe let us know so that we can order enough materials. And also, we're going to start the ham dinners. First one should be October 12th. Talk to some of you if you're interested and can help. Just give me a call and let me know. Thank you.
Are there any other announcements? If you will join me, please, in the opening prayer. Holy Father, and Maker of heaven and earth, you have made all things according to your word. God of flesh, you have made us the head of creation. We are here to worship you and praise your name. May our worship be accepted by you. Let us ride on the wings of our praises and refresh our spirits in you. As we begin today, guide us toward your will. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Our opening hymn will be He Leadeth Me, verses 1, 2, and 3 on page 1.
Blessed are the word of the heavenly God.
call to worship. Are any among you suffering?
Then let us pray.
Are any cheerful?
Then let us sing songs of praise.
Are any among you sick?
Then let us turn to each other for God's healing touch.
The prayer of faith will save us.
And God will lift us up.
Are there any praises or concerns that anybody would like to share?
Joanne Fowler is my brother's mother-in-law. She's in Altman Hospital, not doing very well.
Karen?
Richard's been able to come two Sundays in a row now, so welcome, Richard.
Good to see you again. I saw him 2 weeks ago, actually. Anybody else? There is a man in North Carolina. I don't know his name, but I know his son, Lance. He is in the hospital with COVID. He's in ICU on a ventilator. And the doctors say that it doesn't look good, but we know God, right? We know him. He's the only one that knows exactly his fate for Lance's father. So I told them to just keep on praying. So I would like all of you to join in on that prayer, not just today, but every day this week. That you think about it, stop and pray, please. Anybody else? Okay, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning to praise and worship you. We also come this morning so that our minds are renewed, our hearts are filled with your joy, and our bodies restored, refueled for the challenges that we will face in the coming week. We praise your name for the awesome God that you are. You have walked alongside us in many ways this past week. You have seen us through our struggles. You have strengthened us when we were weak, and you have brought healing to those of us that needed it. I praise your name for being with my family, especially Victoria. You have helped her to get through one of the worst fears these days. Thank you, Jesus, for allowing her to have minor symptoms and be able to get rid of COVID as fast as she got it. I praise your name for being with George and myself, keeping us from getting COVID. There are others, Lord, that have not been so blessed. They continue to struggle, especially a friend of our family, Lance's father. Extend your healing hand upon him, allowing him to be healed, and in his healing, allow those around him to see you. We thank you, Lord, for the care that you have been given to our church family members in their time of need. We lift those that need you more than we do. Dorothy, Doris, Carl, Gail, Betty, Mary Ellen, Norma, and I know, dear Lord, there is more on this list. So I ask, dear Lord, that we stop and mention the names that we know, dear Lord, on our hearts. We join Anne in lifting to you, Joanne, as she also gets word, dear Lord, from the doctors that things don't look too good. But dear Heavenly Father, that is when you move the mightiest. So so that the healing that is given, dear Lord, can be no question that it came from you. So we know, dear Lord, that you know her fate, your will for her life. So I ask you, dear Lord, to extend your healing hand upon her and allow your will to be done. We do praise your name, dear Lord, for Richard being able to join us in person. And I thank you, dear Lord, for all those that continue to come, not just here in person, dear Lord, but those that join us virtually. I praise your name, dear Lord, for being able to share our service here with others, dear Lord, that can't make it. Whether it be watching us live or watching a recording or reading the prayers and the sermons that we have in the week, dear Lord. I thank you, dear Lord, for allowing us to be able to touch as many as we can. But dear Heavenly Father, I know that there are probably more, not probably, but is, more that need to know you in this community, maybe people that we don't even know. I ask you, dear Lord, to bring them across our paths. Help us to recognize the opportunities that you give to us as your church to share you, to share your love, to share, dear Lord, what we have and allow them to know that they can have it too. Dear Heavenly Father, I praise your name for the kids' club, the teachers that have agreed to be with these children that you will send. Dear Heavenly Father, I ask that you put a hedge of protection around all of them. I ask you, dear Lord, to keep them safe and healthy. And I ask you, dear Lord, to be with us as we nurture them to know you, to draw near to you, so that they can live their life, dear Lord, for you. And know exactly, dear Lord, what that looks like and what that feels like. So when they grow older, dear Lord, they will continue to know you and continue to seek your face in all things. Dear Heavenly Father, I praise your name for allowing us to be your church. And I ask you, dear Lord, to lay upon each of our hearts the part you would like us to play. The things that you would like us to do, the ministries you would like us to have, and help us to know, dear Lord, without a doubt, that you will be with us, you will walk with us, you will guide us, you will equip us, and you will help us to grow your church, to bear fruit, to nurture the hearts, dear Lord, that have been hardened. And this we pray, dear Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
If you would join with me now in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen and amen. please have ushers come forward, please?
Gifts to you this morning. We pray that
6:13 through 20. Is anyone among you suffering? Let him pray. Is any cheerful? Let him sing praise. Is any among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church, and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will save the sick man, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed sins, he will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another, and pray for one another that you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous man has great power in its effects. Elijah was a man of like nature with ourselves, and he prayed fervently that it might not rain. And for 3 years and 6 months, it did not rain on the earth. Then he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth brought forth its fruit. My brethren, if anyone among you wanders from the truth, and someone brings him back, let him know that whoever brings back a sinner from the error of his way will save his soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. May God add his blessing to this reading of his word.
The gospel reading today comes from Mark chapter 9, verses 38 through 50. Now John answered him, saying, Teacher, we saw someone who does not follow us casting out demons in your name, and we forbade him because he does not follow us. But Jesus said, Do not forbid him, for no one who works a miracle in my name can soon afterwards seek evil of me. For he who is not against us is on our side. For whoever gives you a cup of water to drink in my name, because you belong to Christ, assuredly I say to you, he will by no means lose his reward. But whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to stumble, it would be better for him if a millstone were hung around his neck and he were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed rather than having two hands to go to hell, into the fire that shall never be quenched, where their worm does not die and the fire is not quenched. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life lame rather than having 2 feet to be cast into hell, into the fire that shall never be quenched, where their worm does not die and the fire is not quenched. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye rather than having 2 eyes to be cast into hell fire, where their worm does not die and the fire is not quenched. For everyone will be seasoned with fire, and every sacrifice will be seasoned with salt. Salt is good, but if the salt loses its flavor, how will you season it? Have salt in yourselves and have peace with one another. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,
We thank you so much for allowing us to be in your house this morning, to praise your name, to worship you, to hear your word, and to hear your message. I thank you once again, dear Lord, for allowing me to be your messenger here this morning. So I ask you, dear Lord, to fill me with your spirit, so that the message that is given is yours and not my own. I ask you, dear Lord, to fill all of us with your spirit, helping us to feel you moving within us, helping us to hear the words you have for us, and helping us, dear Lord, to leave your house this morning with the desire burning within us to share you with others. In this I pray, dear Lord, in Jesus' name, amen. It really is good to be back here, and I praise God for John Blacon that was here yesterday, last Sunday. I heard he did a good job and told a few jokes. I don't have any jokes for you this morning, but I do have an illustration that I would like to share. It's called Invalids' Prayers Bring Revival. Max Lucado told church in Scotland back in the 1940s that was struggling to keep the doors open. A couple of its members were two older ladies who were invalids and couldn't get out for worship any longer. But these ladies refused to allow their infirmities to get in the way of serving their God. They became convinced that their community needed Jesus desperately, and they were going to do something about it. They were going to pray. They determined to make their house a house of prayer. Around the clock, they prayed for God to do something powerful. Then one day, one of the ladies became convinced that God wanted a revivalist by the name of Campbell to come and hold meetings at their church. They talked to their preacher, and he contacted Campbell, but Campbell was unavailable. He was booked up. The women refused to give up in their prayers, however, and it wasn't long before, oddly enough, some of Campbell's other revivals became canceled, and he decided to accept the invitation of that small church. He arrived and held 5 weeks of meetings. The revival was so well received that hundreds showed up each night. And lives were so changed that many of the local taverns had to close up because they lacked patrons. One might think it was because of the powerful preaching of a renowned revivalist, but in reality, it was because of the faithfulness of two invalid older ladies who dedicated themselves to prayer. How many here truly believe in the power of prayer?
Amen.
When we pray, we are in communication with our God. We bring to Him all the things that have been brought to us, asking Him to make them right. Fervently, we ask our God for healing, for guidance, for help with our finances, for nice weather, to take care of our children when we feel that we cannot. When we pray these things, do we expect God to answer the prayers? Do we expect Him to do what we are asking, even when it seems impossible? In our communication with our God, do we praise Him for all the prayers that has been answered? Do we praise Him for the things that we were blessed with, even the things that we didn't ask for? When we pray to our God, we need to, without a doubt, believe that He hears our prayers, and He can do what we are asking. When we pray to our God, we need to expect a miracle. because our God is a miracle worker. Amen?
Yes.
When my girls were very little, I believe they were maybe 7 and 5, my dad got very sick. And my girls loved their grandfather. And they prayed really hard every night when they went to bed for their grandfather to get better. My dad was so sick that the doctors had given him possibly 3 months to live. And I'm telling you, when the doctors told me that, I felt in my heart like, really? Really? 3 months? Like, where did that come from? I don't know. I know that the doctors, they look at it through science. And in my father's condition, they had no record of someone pulling through. Every night we would pray, and I knew that my girls need God to answer their prayers. When I visited my father, I did not see the science. I have seen the possibility of God allowing him to regain his strength and to return home with us. Every day, I would see a little improvement, and every day, I would talk to the doctors and I would ask, did you change your mind yet? The doctors still were saying he only had a few months to live, but I praise God that he found favor in my father and my daughters. As he answered their prayers and allowed my father to regain his health, enough for him to share life with my daughters for a little while longer. God doesn't always answer our prayers in the way that we ask him to. A couple of years later, my father got sick again, and in those couple years, he was given to be with us. Little by little, his health did start to fail. This time, we prayed again for God's healing of their grandpa. But I believe after my father was in the hospital for a few days, I felt in my heart that he wasn't going to return home. And in a matter of 48 hours, my dad was called home to be with the Lord. But this time it was different, because this time I knew that God answered our prayers the first time to find favor with my daughters, so my daughters could see the mighty works of their God, so that their faith in him could start in themselves. They saw him work mighty things. And they became faithful. They became trusting to their God. The second time around, they were old enough to understand that my father was sick. Their grandfather was sick, and he wasn't going to get better. He was just going to get worse. And it was time for God to start taking care of my father instead of us. We come to know that God's answer to our prayers are the perfect answer. Amen? Over the years, I have seen God work many miracles in my life and in the lives of others. Even though he doesn't always give us a miracle when we pray for one, we should expect a miracle only because he can give you one if it is in his plan. Amen. I was just talking to someone a couple of weeks ago, and I asked her, how do you want us to pray? She said to me, I don't want a miracle. Because me, I'm always praying for a miracle. And I know you've heard me say, as long as there is breath, there is hope. She said, I don't want a miracle. I just want this to be all over. I just want to get on with it. And when she said that, she meant, I just want to meet my Maker and live my eternal life, the one that we're promised. So sometimes we need to ask the person, how do you want us to pray for you? Because we tend to pray in the way that we would want the end result to happen. Amen. Healing isn't the only miracle that he gives. He opens doors for us to walk through that will take us to places we would never take ourselves. But we need to believe wholeheartedly that when we walk through those doors, he will be with us. He will equip us. And he will allow us to succeed in his name. Just like the kids' club. We can look around our church today and we can see there's no children. But we have to believe that when we open the doors and ask the children to come, he will send them. You have to believe that. And the children that he sends, we need to be ready. And we're ready, right, Karen? We're ready. We're ready to see what God has in store for us. What God has in store for the little ones that come through the doors. And there is nothing better than to hear little voices echoing through the hallways of a church. Amen? Praying in his name and singing and giggling. And running, and us yelling, don't run! We will be praising God's name for the little voices that come through the doors this week. For the two ladies in the illustration, it would have been very easy for them to just look at themselves and say, what can we do? We're old, and not only that, we're disabled. But they heard the calling of their God. They joined together in prayer and never gave up on what they were praying for. They became convinced that their community needed Jesus. Does that sound familiar? Let's be convinced that our community needs Jesus. Because you know what? They do. All communities need Jesus. Amen. And they were going to do something about it. They were going to pray. They kept their hearts, minds, and souls open to the moving of the Holy Spirit. They prayed for revival, and even when their plan fell through, they continued to pray because they knew that that was laid on their heart by God. And you know what? It happened. And I will tell you from experience, when God lays something on your heart, it will never go away. Okay? It will never go away. It will continue to lay there until you do something about it. And there will be things that will stop you or try to stop you from doing what he's asking you to do. But you need to be like these two ladies in the illustration and keep on pushing through. Keep on moving on. Because in the end, the victory is his. Amen? The power of prayer is strong, and we have prayer warriors that lift all concerns in prayer. And I believe, they faithfully believe, that God hears our prayers. One of the things many of us forget to do is pray for ourselves. Amen? So, I'm going to ask you to do something that may make you feel a little uncomfortable, but hopefully not. I would like for each one of you, whoever you are sitting by, close to, even if it's your wife or your husband, or your mom, or your son, or your choir director, or whoever is sitting around you, I want you to take a moment now. you to tell the person next to you what you need prayer for. And once you find out what you need a prayer for, to be prayed for, I want you to pray for that person. We understand? So we're going to take a time in our worship service today praying for each other. Now, if somebody would like me to pray with you, you can either come to the altar, you're welcome to come to the altar and I will pray with you, or raise your hand and I will come to you. So let's be in a time of prayer. One thing, tell the person next to you what you want them to pray for you. Let's pray.
Doesn't it feel good to be in a time of prayer in God's house?
Yes.
I would like all of you to take that prayer request that you heard today home with you. And I want you to be in continued prayer throughout the week for that person, for that thing that you prayed for them. I would also like to ask all of us in this church to be like those ladies that were in fervent prayer for revival of their church, for revival of their community. So I ask you to take time out this week, spend time on your knees, standing, however you pray the best. Be in prayer for this community, for revival, for opening the hearts of people for Jesus. And do it expecting a miracle. Amen.
Amen.
Let's pray.
Susie, you're my
I shut it off.
There you go. Dear Heavenly Father, we have come to you today to hear your word, your message, and your calling upon our lives. We thank you for the opportunity to with you through what we call prayer. We join together now and lift to you all of the prayers that were spoken today. And we lift to you those prayers that remain in our hearts for only you to hear. Guide us and keep us near to you. we may hear your answer to our prayers, and may we accept your answer and come to know that it is aligning us with your will in our lives. We do ask that you stir the hearts of many in this community, allowing them to know that we need you, that they need you. Help us to help bring a revival to this community so that we don't just look different because there are many people, but instead we look different because we are your people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The doors to allow that.